Welcome to the Tennis Warehouse Racquet Review of the Head Graphene Touch Speed Pro. The ever-popular Speed Pro gets updated with a softer material for improved shock absorption and a more comfortable feel. Head's graphene technology is still used in the throat of the racquet, allowing weight to be polarized towards the end of the frame for more power and stability. First up, we've got the one and only Michelle. I know you're a fan of heavier racquets, but typically more open string patterns, and this one's got a real dense 1820. How did it work out for you?
Yeah, I enjoyed this playtest. I was actually looking at my comments from the previous version and the version before that, and I've always said that I actually get along with this racquet when it comes to 18 by 20s, and this was no different. I personally found this to be my favorite out of the last three iterations of this racquet. It does have a bit of a more muted feel, which is something I gravitate towards. I really enjoy that powerful response right off the ground. And with the 18 by 20, I felt like I could still hit my targets, but I was getting a nice step and I could go after the ball and I wasn't hurt. There was built-in control, which is exactly what my game needs. On serve, again, I'm able to hit a big, powerful serve, but my most effective serves are when I pick my targets and go after them. So that was really helpful with this racquet. And on return, also, I love that it has that built-in control. So when I do have a tendency to swing too big or a little too much power, this racquet kind of helps me reel it all back in. Great playtest for me. I'm just not ready to switch to that 18 by 20 string pattern yet.
Next up, we've got Troy once again matching his stick-it-wear shirt to the review. Love it. Contrary to Michelle, I know you're a big fan of that tighter 18 by 20 string pattern. So how did this work for you?
Yeah, definitely this tight string pattern really allowed me to trust in the racquet from all areas of the court. And that's one thing that I have liked about this racquet going back to the graphene. Similar feel, but just really good predictability from the baseline at the net and even on serve. I just felt like I was really in control of the ball, and I think this is one thing for a 100 square inch head size compared to some other 100 square inches. This is probably the best control for that head size. But being so close together with the strings, it's even tighter, I think, than my Blade 1820. It did limit the spin a little bit, like on kick serves and slice serves, and sometimes on like a heavy topspin forehand. I just wasn't quite getting that topspin that you would get from like a 16-19. So a little bit of trade-off there. But overall, this is a crisp, firm feeling racquet, but hence the name Touch. It really does a good job of cutting out the vibrations. So much that I almost felt like it lacked a little feedback, and me being really traditional with my rackets coming from like a 6195, I just didn't feel the ball all the time on like touch volleys and whatnot. But for a modern feeling racket, 100 square inches, this really adds some control compared to like an AeroPro drive or something like that. So good baseline racket.
Next up, we've got Chris. I know you've been on the reviews for the previous versions of this racket like the other guys. How has this one worked out for you?
Right off the bat, from the very first hit, I noticed a bit more of a muted feel to this racket. And I also thought it was a little less powerful compared to the previous version. So I had it strung a couple of different ways, because at first I was wondering if it was just the string that was sapping some of the power out of the racket. But it definitely upped the level of control for me. I felt like I could stay on the gas a bit more with this update than I could on the previous version. And for that, I really liked it when I was inside the court, attacking the ball when I had an opportunity to have a good crack at a short ball. I felt more confident with this racket in my hand just because I was getting the ball to drop faster inside, to get it to drop inside the baseline, could really get dial in on that control. And a big part of that was also because I was getting more spin. So I was bringing a lot more racket head speed to each swing, and it was upping the rotation I was getting on the ball. So combination of the racket being lower powered, giving me a bit more spin and bite on those approach shots. On the serve is where it hurt me. I just needed a little bit more power. I was really missing the power of my Pure Drive Plus on serve, but my consistency was great. I could really find my targets well, getting again, ton of spin. And I know you enjoyed this racket at net, and like you, on the drop volleys, angle volleys, it really is a point and shoot racket. Very accurate, very precise feeling racket. I would like it just to have a little bit more power, but I can get that back by stringing it a little lower or maybe switching up to a hybrid.
I also got to be on this playtest, and I've been a fan of the Speed Pro for a while. I didn't think this was too much of a departure from the other ones in terms of performance. It's got a pretty similar feel to it, and if you're fans of the previous version, you're gonna get a pretty similar response out of this. And one of the things that I find in the Speed Pro line, especially with that really dense string pattern, it produces a really low trajectory off of the string bed. And what that allows me to do, or forces me to do, is swing much more low to high on my ground strokes, especially my topspin ground strokes, and that enables me to get a lot more spin than I might normally get with another racquet. And because of that, the Speed Pro has always been one of my favorite rackets to hit with from the baseline and on the return of serve. On the volley, I did find it to be pretty point and shoot, great control, but kind of like what Troy alluded to, the feel is a bit dampened and muted, and I did have a little bit of trouble going for touch or more finesse shots because I was a little bit less connected to the ball than I had felt in previous versions. On serve, loved it, got the control I needed, got the spin I needed, and got nice pop out of it. And all in all, a nice update here. I like this better than the Graphene XT line. I thought it's much more comfortable, but yet it's not quite as responsive as the original Graphene. For this playtest, we had the racket strung up with Solinko Hyper G at 51 pounds. We also had another racket we were hitting with a hybrid with a multi-filament in the mains and a poly in the crosses. If you want to learn more, be sure to come to Tennis Warehouse or one of our fine affiliates. Thanks for watching.